Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, we will continue exploring RoboDK's environment, particularly we will concentrate on the robot panel. This is a very important feature of the UI, so you really need to understand it properly. You will spend a lot of time playing with the robot position, joint values, and configuration, so I really want you to have a good understanding of each of these features. Let's jump right into it. As mentioned, the robot panel is very important. You can reach it easily by double-clicking directly on the robot. You will find it here on your right. You can also reach it by right-clicking the robot and selecting Options, or double-clicking on the robot in the Station Tree. By the way, clicking on a 3D object in the 3D environment or clicking on its reference in the Station Tree will give you the exact same result. Double-click here, Robot Panel. The robot panel will bring you very useful information. Obviously, the name of the robot. You will have here which tool is activated. In this case, we only have one tool, so there is no other choice. But if we had more than one, we could choose from here. It's the tool frame with respect to the robot flange. So this position here, the TCP with respect to the robot flange. Here are the numbers representing this position here with rotation. You will then have the reference frame with respect to the robot base. So in this case here, we only have one reference frame. I'm going to talk about reference frame later in another video, so don't worry about that. But for now, we only have one, so we only have one choice. And this position will obviously be zero with respect to itself. You then have the position of the tool with respect to the robot reference frame. So if I was to put the robot to its side like that, and if we were to look at the values we have here, so 626.5 millimeters along the in the red box, meaning the red axis or the x-axis. So that means that this TCP here is 626 millimeter away from the robot base right here. Zero in Y because we are straight here. And 807 millimeter in Z, so the height here. And then we have the rotation. So very useful information. I will talk later about the Euler angle formats, so how the rotations are represented. But here, I would just tell you for now that you need to look at what values you can see here, what letters you can see here, to define what are the rotations you have here. So Z, Y prime, or X prime prime. You will then have a small section here to jog the robot around. So that will be useful. We'll talk about that in the next video. You have also the robot workspace here. So right now we don't show any workspace, but we could show the workspace of the robot at the wrist. We could show the workspace of the robot at the flange of the robot. So the wrist is here where joint 5 is. The flange is at the end of the joint 6 and where the current tool is sitting. I would recommend you to use either the flange or the wrist to really define if an object is reachable, except if you have a very long tool, because if you are completely extended, sometimes you lose a bit of flexibility to do your motion. So it's not because the robot can reach a point and it can actually work at that spot. Let's go back to no work zone. You can then show some frames, so I could show the tool or show the reference frame. This is the exact same thing as right click here, visible reference frame, right click visible robot flange, right click visible tool frame. Here, underneath you can see the joint axis jog, so you could move the robot one joint at a time. So like this, like that. Here, bring it back to its own position. You can see the value here of each joint. You can enter a value manually, so zero here, let's say. So you can enter value here, click back to home. And then underneath here, you will have the different robot configurations. So we will have a video especially on robot configuration in the next few videos. But here you can select the different configuration or set of joints available to reach a given position with that robot here. You can also reach the same kind of panel by double-clicking directly on, let's say, the TCP. It will bring you a panel with a lot less information because there's not much to say about the tool except the values of the TCP position. Same goes for our reference frame. Again, the only thing we need to know about our reference frame is its position. So there's not as much information, but it's still valuable information. And okay, another thing that I want to show you, if you press your forward slash button on your keyboard, you will see the name of the tool and frame appearing here. If we had other stuff in our station, we would also see the other stuff. So that can be useful if you want to kind of match some information from your station tree with the information you have in your 3D environment. So this is forward slash. So as I said before, plus or minus, increase or decrease the size of the reference frame, forward slash bring the names, and if you press on the star button, you will see the robot workspace. One last thing before we end this video. As I already said, I've been creating a tutorial or training content on YouTube for 3 years now, so there's a lot of stuff already there. So sometimes during the videos, I'm gonna refer to some of those videos to kind of give you more info. So for this one, if you want to take a look at robot part one and robot part two, you are very welcome to do so. There's much more info here than what I cover. So I go more in depth, let's say, in these 26 minutes as I would do in like 10 minutes here in the training. So if you have the time, if you want to know more about that, if you want to know more about that, I would recommend you to go and take a look here. In the next video, we will start moving the robot around. So learn how to move the robot either in a Cartesian way or a joint way. So this will be the main subject of the next video. So hope to see you there. Have a great day, guys.